Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Demon's Souls Remake. My next order of business is going to be to grab the Storm Ruler. I do not want to actually kill the Storm King yet. There are a couple of things I want to do here first, but I need to make sure that I have enough inventory space for it, which it looks like I do. Okay. Now, it doesn't matter if I die here, because I need this place to stay pure black. And I'm gonna have to die in body form anyway in order to ensure that that happens. Okay, now, I don't believe these guys care about soul remains. I'm pretty sure they don't. They don't. So, the best thing you can do is put on the thief ring and just keep moving. Until you've got this. Now, if I remember correctly, if you come all the way to the tip of the peninsula, the storm beast flying around over there will not attack you. And the big boy won't bother with you either until you start killing some of the little ones. So what we can do here... Actually, I should keep this on, because... Yeah, I'm not going to be using the bow, but I can use magic. What we're going to do is we're going to equip the Providential Ring. And I am going to... find the crystal lizards that are wandering around here. And we're going to get rid of any of the storm beasts that find their way over. Ah. Damn it, did the lizards disappear already? I think they might have. This, by the way, this little arch here, this is probably the safest spot outside of the house. It's not totally safe, but... Alright, well... crystal lizards are gone. Then I need to get rid of some storm beasts so that I can safely switch to my catalyst, or talisman rather. And for reasons that I'm sure are quite obvious, in pure black world tendency, this boss room is a preferred farming spot. 50.3, great. Okay, so... I need the Storm Ruler, first of all, for getting rid of Black Phantom Satsuki.
I can forge weapons. Do come back alive.
And I also need it... to demonstrate the soul farming run. And before we do that, I need to die here so that we get back to pure black. And then we need to update World Tendency by warping to this same Archstone. World Tendency has updated. So, the farming run is basically the same no matter what level you are. The only difference is what tools you use. Because if you come back here on a higher level character as a mage, then you'll have tools like Soul Suck and Soul Thirst to increase the amount of souls you get. At minimum, if you have the Ring of Avarice, you should use it. And if you're on a female character, you should use the Silver Bracelets. Don't get me started on why that's just one more reason it's so stupid that Bluepoint insisted on continuing to use gender-locked armor. Because the Silver Bracelets can't be used by a male character. And they give you a 20% soul boost to the souls you gain, which only female characters can have. So what you do... And I'm just gonna swap in the bow here, because I want to stay under 50% equip weight. Is you shoot this idiot with a bow. There, idiot's dead. And that clears out all the Shadow Lurkers on your way back. Then... you take your handy little Storm Ruler, you walk out here, and you swat this idiot straight off the edge. Then you come over here, and you do the same thing to these guys. Hyper armor? What hyper armor? Next, you kill this idiot. And then... you kill that idiot. And then if you're feeling really spiteful, you come up here. And you kill these idiots. And that's it. None of the rest of these enemies are worth trying to kill. Because they give you crap for souls, the Silver Skeletons, even in pure black World Tendency. And then that's the run. Then... you just put on your Talisman of God and cast Evacuate. And that's a substantial amount of souls for, what, a minute? Minute and a half? And just think of how many souls you get out of that if you do so using Soul Suck and Soul Thirst and the Ring of Avarice and the Silver Gauntlets, or the Silver Bracelets, rather. None of which I actually have. All right, so now...
long been acquainted.
I need some more arrows.
Nice.
Those can go in storage too. Those take up a lot of room and I don't need them. Nah, that I don't need either. I don't need to be carrying weapon buff items around. This can go to storage. Okay, and I think that should do it. I'm probably just going to die again and lose all these souls, but it's fine because it's now very easy to get them back. Let me just make sure. Okay, I am indeed wearing the thief ring. So let's go deal with Black Phantom Satsuki. The Storm Ruler makes it a relatively easy proposition. Oh, he's not here. What do you mean he's not here? Oh, are we still not at pure black? I guess not. Okay, well, I guess I need to go grab an ephemeral eye stone from storage. Let's just go take care of that, real quick. Never mind the fact that I have 99 of these, it's not important.
We are indebted.
A friendly phantom dropped some. All right, I guess I need to do this again. Alright, we should be able to update World Tendency just by warping straight back. Yeah, there he is. Okay, so what I want to do here is I want to switch this back to the Ring of Magical Sharpness, switch this back to the bow. And I want to get... See, that stupid arm swing attack. You want to go just far enough ahead to get the skeleton to stand up, because you can't damage him if he's not standing up. And then, as long as you're wearing the thief ring, Satsuki will run towards you a little bit and then forget about you. This guy, we want to lure him separately. And then get rid of him. Whenever Satsuki sprints at you, he will always do the running forward thrust. Get out of here. I need him to leave me alone for a moment so I can set the rest of this up. And he's already forgotten. Perfect. And then he'll just turn around. At which point... I can swap in the crisp blade. And... Okay, that's not really how I was hoping that whole thing would go. Let's give it another shot. Yoink! Not that I needed this. Alright, fine. You know what? Just gonna... We're gonna break line of sight. Unless he tries to attack me through the wall. Nope. Let's just use the old photo mode. Okay, he turned around. So we're good to go. That being the case... quite how I was hoping that would go. There we are. So, now... These guys are really stupid, and they can't hear. They detect only by sight, so they won't detect you if you're standing right behind them. And this... I do not need this guy getting in my way here. Alright, very good. So... what we're gonna do... is get his attention. And in relatively short order, he's gonna go on a nice little trip. Now, what we do from here in order to get the drop from him, not that it matters because I won't be leveling dexterity on this character, is we relog, and it should be at his spawn point. Yes, it is. Okay. And it is a hiltless katana. Now, be warned, I ran into a bug during my first playthrough of the remake where I... came here in pure white world tendency, and I gave him the Makoto, and then I killed him that way by knocking him off the cliff. And the Makoto never respawned. It never reappeared the way that the Hiltless does here like it's supposed to. And I ended up losing my Makoto on that first character. So be careful. Ah, come on. Well, that was my fault. Fortunately, it won't affect world tendency. Buddy, I know you saw me. And it doesn't matter if you break the Storm Ruler. It makes no difference, because it still has its knockdown effect even when it's broken. The reason I like it for the skeletons is because... it knocks them down and stops them from rolling. But the Crescent Falchion is probably smarter anyway. All right. Now for him. Now, it bears mentioning, I did try the shortcut here. This one, the one that that lets you get the Crescent Falchion. I did try it off camera, and I was eventually able to get it to work. It is incredibly specific and highly unreliable and not really suitable for speedrun tech because it's so unreliable, but it can be done. I have definitely confirmed it myself. All right. I do have the Ring of Magical Sharpness on. Get rid of those guys. Rid of this guy. Because we now have to get to the primeval demon without warping or leaving the area. And the primeval demon is in 4-2. So let me actually put on the providential ring here so that I can maximize the chances of getting a good drop from Shiny over here. Oh, God. There we go. Indeed! Another chunk. Excellent. And actually, we can stay as we are now because... that's fine. Alright, I'm not taking any risks with this guy. Just gonna sneak right on by and rest at the Archstone. Well, not rest, but just examine it. because that now sets your respawn point here. And now it's a simple matter of making it to the primeval demon. Although, I kind of want to see if... I want to see if I can manage to get a pure blade stone from Angry Boy over here, because I have gotten one before. So I think I will actually just kill him. Oh, this is gonna take forever. Well, maybe not. And that's why we touched the Archstone. So that we end up back here. I shouldn't have gotten too greedy. But it's fine. You see how that works. Let me try that again, but better. Actually, let me trigger this first. There we go. Ah, come on. Oh, now you see me. This jerk. There we go. In before pure blade stone. Nah, that's fine. Again, I don't need it. I just thought it would be funny if we could get one. Now, back to the thief ring, because the storm beasts out here will kill you if you're not wearing it, and the nearer ones can target you even if you are. Case in point. Screw you, jerk. Yeah, this is the guy you want to get rid of. Because he'll really ruin your day. Okay. Providential Ring is equipped. Primeval Demon is there. Oh, good! A pure Moonshade Stone. That's perfect. The worst thing about this particular Primeval Demon is that they placed him blocking the path, and you can't get past him unless you kill him. This here is the White Bow. Very good for higher level characters. Not so much for me. Okay. Well. So that's going to be near pure white world tendency. I say near pure white because that means one level below pure white. And this lovely little treasure here is going to get us to +5 on the Crescent Falchion. And the reason we were able to increase the drop rate on this enough to actually get it is because we are in pure black world tendency and we're wearing the Providential Ring. The Providential Ring only seems to make a small difference because if you look at what it does to the luck stat, or rather to the item discovery stat, you see, item discovery with this on is 68. With it off goes down to 48. So it's a small boost, all things considered. Item discovery, I believe, caps at 110 or somewhere around there. But it's a significant boost if you're not planning on leveling luck, which there's no reason to ever do unless you're using a blue blood sword. So this has worked out brilliantly. And I could not be happier. What we can do now, therefore, is we can head back to the Nexus, repair the Storm Ruler, because goodness knows we're going to need that. And then we can go kill the Storm King.
Do come back alive.
Or actually, even before we kill the Storm King, we need to go have a word with Ed. Because once the Crescent Falchion is at +5, I will be able to use it to deal with the Flame Lurker. Not that I can't also just poison the Flame Lurker. I do kind of want to show that strat, too.
Demon souls, they're like powerful spirits. Some can even bless weapons. But doing so requires a powerful flame, invigorated by a demon soul of scorching heat.
For the soul of a demon is an inferno of wrath! Man, I miss that line. So that's +5 on the Crescent Falchion. Now, we need Spider Stone.
All done.
And the only good place to get Spider Stone is from that stupid crystal lizard. Which I don't want to go kill until I get this zone to pure black world tendency. Oh, and before I forget, this needs to go in storage where I can't accidentally use it. Okay, so let me think here. I think the plan should be Satsuki, for starters. Because I am going to want that Makoto for hyper mode. And Satsuki is going to require that we kill the Storm King, so Storm Ruler first. And actually, since we got the pure Dark Moonstone, I won't need to farm out the Crystal Lizards in this boss room anymore, which is incredibly lucky. That has saved quite a bit of time and annoyance. So let's get the Storm King out of the way. That roar just now sounded like a pitched-down moo from a cow. I'll have to go back through and post and speed these up to see what sound effects they were actually derived from. Oh, another thing I wanted to do. Another thing I wanted to do is to see what the projectiles look like that the Storm King shoots. And we're gonna have to move over to this side of the house now, because this wasn't the case in the original, but now when he comes in from this side, He can hit you with these. And actually, I wanted to see what the projectiles are. That's interesting. These are, they're apparently larval storm beasts, which I think is what they were in the original as well. But now they're a little bit easier to see because we have the benediction of photo mode. But I wanted to show this off because it's really neat that he's basically throwing his children at you. Ah, you used to be able to hit the hindquarters. What we can do, though, now what we used to be able to do. You used to be able to hit him with this a little more easily, but this, I think, yeah, some arrows. They give you arrows here as a hint at what you're supposed to do. Oh, you're the one that I miss. That's no good. Oh, come the hell on. Soul Ray has longer range, so if you have it when you come here, it's easier to hit him with it. But I feel like the Storm Ruler has more trouble hitting him in the remake than it did in the original. You used to be able to hit him with it two, occasionally three times every time he made a pass in, but now you're lucky if you even hit him once. I don't know what Blue Point did, but they seem to have screwed it up somehow. One more will do it. There we go. Very good indeed. And now that we've beaten an archdemon, we get the Nexial Agent, which is something that should not exist as an item. It should have been given to us as soon as we got the Nexial Binding. But what it does is it lets us warp between Archstone zones. And I don't mean like from 4-1 to 4-2. I mean from 4-1 to 2-1. The Nexial Agent allows the user freedom to travel between regions as though stepping through the Nexus. So it basically lets you skip the Nexus. So now you'll see that up at the top, we've got a little selector tab where we can cycle through each Archstone area and warp straight from here. Also, I am not fond of the fact that this is a separate item and that they make you wait so long for it. Alright, so now I want to... I guess I should just go back to the Nexus.
I can forge weapons. Do come back alive.
Alright. I like how the Storm Demon's soul is slightly shaped like a lightning bolt. So we're going to send this to storage because we can't use it just yet.
I was worried sick.
Seeds, sages, and all manner of wise men watch over the halls of this Nexus. This rejuvenated sanctum is a fine place for the slayers of demons to rest their weary bones. I, too, must contribute how I can, for we are indebted to our honorable defenders. What is the world like outside the Nexus now? With brave souls like you confronting those vile demons, perhaps it won't be long before things return to normal. What a fine day that would be. Perhaps it won't be long before a fine day that would be.
Hey, don't worry, Thomas. If I find an extra spine in my travels, I'll bring it back for you. Okay. Oh, right. The white bow can go in. I don't need that. The holy arrows and the white arrows can also go in.
We are indebted to you.
Okay. Satsuki. Oh, actually, first I need to go get the Makoto. I totally forgot. Very good. Oh, right, I forgot. Whoops, no. Ah. Okay. And there she is. Magic Sword Makoto. This'll probably be the fastest way of getting back out of here. And now we deal with Satsuki. Little bit easier now. But before we talk to him... Yes, I know you're there. I know you're there. One thing at a time, please. All right, I still have the thief ring on, right? Yes, I do. Okay. Now then.
I am Satsuki. I seek a keepsake of my father. Have you seen the sword inscribed Makoto? I will offer you demon swords if you can help me find it. You have found the Makoto, have you? Bless your good fortune, and, well, good work. Now, just hand Makoto over to me.
How about no?
What on earth is wrong with you? How dare you waste my precious time? Do you not want demon sword?
Your precious time. Because you were so busy standing here in the rain, getting soaked and doing nothing.
Fine. You've made your choice. Now, I make mine.
Yes, Satsuki, indeed you do. Indeed you do. All right, fine. Loser. That was how I lost the Makoto on my first character, is I gave it to him here, and then I slapped him off the edge, figuring, yeah, it'll just respawn where it's supposed to respawn when I exit the game and reload, right? Well, turns out, no, that didn't happen. Now, if you don't give him the Makoto, he will drop nothing. But if you do give him the Makoto, he is supposed to drop it again when you kill him, because otherwise, how would you get it back? Alright, now, killing him once he's hostile to you through dialogue during the quest should not affect world tendency, if I remember correctly. Ah, it does. Okay, for some reason I thought I remembered that it didn't, but I guess that answers that. Well, so much the better, actually. It makes it easier for me to get the Shrine of Storms back to pure black world tendency.
Oh, thank goodness. I was worried sick.
So, the Makoto can go in.
We are indebted to you.
I can forge weapons for you.
All right,
You come back alive.
So the next order of business is Stonefang, I think, because I do want to open up the blacksmith shop, edge shop, for being able to craft boss weapons. But first, I think I might need some more ephemeral eye stones, because I'm going to need to get Stonefang to pure black. And I want to deal with the Primeval Demon and Black Phantom Skurver there, because I might end up using the Talisman of Beasts on this character. Oh, did I get it already? I guess I did. Blast. Did I get the one in the Pantheon too? I probably did. Let's see. Oh, okay. We are not online. Let's try that again. Oh, good. Wait, what? Now that I think about it, I think I was online. What the heck just happened? Why did I get that message when I tried to go into the Pantheon? Alright, hang on, guys. Sorry, now I'm curious. This wouldn't be the first weird bug I've seen in the remake, if that is indeed what it is. Can't retrieve it in offline mode, and yet I'm clearly online. Because there are bloodstains and messages everywhere. Hang on. Oh, it must be because... Yeah, okay, interesting. Launch state online. Can only be modified from the title screen settings menu. But it should indicate... Is it because I had a password set? What the hell? All right, Blue Point, fine. Fine, I guess I won't go into the Pantheon. Yeah, because see, look, there are messages here with appraisals. That only happens when you're online. There are bloodstains. What the actual... Launch state online. I had the server set to North Virginia because I was playing during peak North American hours a couple of days ago, but I can't imagine. Do we have to maybe continue? Rather than load game? What the hell? Somebody in the comments probably knows exactly what's going on and is screaming at me right now. I'm really sorry. I apologize. I'm just baffled by this. Let's see if I can get in now that I quit the game and turn the password. I wonder if it was just because I had a password set. There we go, okay. Retrieving Pantheon data. Huh. Okay, I'm very confused by that. I have to think it must have just been because I had a password set when I initially logged in. Oh, and after all that, I've already gotten this one too. Well, this sure was much ado about nothing, wasn't it? My apologies, guys. Well, we're at about an hour, so I guess I'm going to call it. Thank you all very much for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Take care, everyone.